Get your dream job with Chennai Race Institute. Read the following information carefully and answer the questions given below. Seven friends A, C, R, V, T, X and Q are living in seven different floors, but not necessarily in the same order. The lowermost floor is numbered as 1 and the above floor is numbered as 2 and so on. R lives on one of the even numbered floor. V is not an immediate neighbor of T. Only two persons live between T and R. Only one person lives between T and Q who does not live immediately above or immediately below R. Four person lives between A and X who lives above A. Number of person between A and C is two times of number of persons between T and Q. Let's draw the diagram based on the information. Here, seven persons A, C, R, V, T, X, and Q, and they are living in seven different floors, but not necessarily in the same order. Here, ground floor is numbered 1, and above floors are numbered 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Go to the first statement. R lives on one of the even numbered floor. Here in diagram, even numbered floors are 2nd floor, 4th floor and 6th floor. So we get 3 possible diagrams. Here in diagram 1, R lives on 2nd floor. Here in diagram 2, R lives on 4th floor. Here in diagram 3, R lives on 6th floor. Go to the next statement. V is not an immediate neighbor of T. Here in all possible diagrams, we don't know the places of V and T. So skip the statement. Later we will discuss. Go to the next statement. Only two persons live between T and R. Here in diagram 1, R lives on 2nd floor. So we have only one floor below the floor of R. So we can't place T on below floor of R. So place T on 5th floor only. So only two persons live between T and R. Here in diagram 2, R lives on 4th floor. So we can place T on 7th floor or 1st floor. Here we get two possible diagrams. In diagram 2A, R lives on 4th floor. So here we can place T on 7th floor. So only two persons live between T and R. In diagram 2B, R lives on 4th floor. So here we can place T on 1st floor. So only two persons live between T and R. In diagram 3, R lives on 6th floor. So here we have only one floor above the floor of R. Here we can't place T on above the floors of R. So place T on 3rd floor. Here only two persons live between T and R. Go to the next statement. Only one person lives between T and Q who does not live immediately above or immediately below of R. Here in diagram 1, T lives on 5th floor. So we can place Q on 7th floor or 3rd floor. Here place Q on 7th floor only because Q does not live immediately above or immediately below R. Here in diagram 2A, T lives on 7th floor. We can't place Q on above floors of T because we don't have floors on above floor of T. Here we can't place Q on 5th floor also because Q does not live immediately above or immediately below R. So cancel this diagram. In diagram 2B, T lives on 1st floor. We can't place Q on below floors of T because we don't have floors on below floor of T. Here, we can't place Q on third floor also because Q does not live immediately above or immediately below R. So cancel this diagram. In diagram 3, T lives on third floor. So Q lives on first floor or fifth floor. But we can't place Q on fifth floor because Q does not live immediately above or immediately below of R. So place Q on first floor only. Go to next statement. Four persons lives between A and X who lives above A. Here in diagram 1, we have to fill first floor, third floor, fourth floor and sixth floor. If we place A on first floor, then place X on sixth floor only because four persons live between A and X must be placed on above A. So place A on first floor and place X on sixth floor. Here in diagram 3, we have to fill second floor, fourth floor, fifth floor and seventh floor. If we place A on second floor, then place X on seventh floor only because four persons live between A and X must be placed on above A. So place A on second floor and place X on seventh floor. Go to the next statement. Number of persons between A and C is 2 times of number of persons between T and Q. Here in diagram 1, Q lives on 7th floor and T lives on 5th floor. In between T and Q, we have only one floor and so in between A and C, we must have 2 floors. Because from the statement, the number of floors between Q and T is twice the number of floors between A and C. So here, A lives on 1st floor. So place C on 4th floor. Here in diagram 3, Q lives on 1st floor and T lives on 3rd floor. In between T and Q, we have only one floor. And in between A and C, we must have 2 floors. Because from the statement, the number of floors between Q and T is twice the number of floors between A and C. So here, A lives on 2nd floor, so place C on 5th floor. Go to the next statement. V is not an immediate neighbour of T. Here in diagram 1, the remaining floor is 3rd floor. So place V on 3rd floor. Here, T lives on 5th floor and V lives on 3rd floor. Here, V is not an immediate neighbour of T. Here in diagram 3, the remaining floor is 4th floor. So place V on 4th floor. Here T lives on 3rd floor and V lives on 4th floor. So V is an immediate neighbour of T. So cancel this diagram. The final diagram is question number 1. Four of the following are alike in a certain way based on the arrangement and hence form a group. Which of the following does not belong to the group? The options are option A, Q, option B, C, option C, T, option D, V, and option E, A. Let's see the solution. Here in diagram, Q lives on 7th floor. T lives on 5th floor. V lives on 3rd floor and A lives on 1st floor and C lives on 4th floor. So here all these persons except C are odd numbered floor. But C lives on even numbered floor. So the answer is option B, C. Question number 2. Which of the following statements is true? Options are option A, Q lives on lowermost floor. Option B, X lives immediately above C. Option C. R lives immediately below V. Option D. All are true. And option E. T lives in even numbered floor. Let's see the solution. Option A. Q lives on lowermost floor. Here in diagram, Q lives on 7th floor. But in the option, they given that Q lives on lowermost floor, that is 1st floor. So option A is not true. Option B. X lives immediately above C. Here in diagram, X lives on 6th floor and C lives on 4th floor. In between X and C, there is one floor. So X not lives on immediately above C. So option B is not true. Option C. R lives immediately below V. Here in diagram, R lives on 2nd floor and V lives on 3rd floor. Here R lives immediately below V. So the option C is true. Option E. T lives on even numbered floor. Here in diagram, T lives on 5th floor. Here 5th floor is not an even numbered floor. So option E is not true. Option D. All are true. Here option A, option B, option E are not true and option C is true. So option D is not true. So the answer is option C. R lives immediately below V. Question number 3. Which of the following combinations is true? Options are option A. Q, 6th floor. Option B. A, 2nd floor. Option C. V, 4th floor. Option D. T, 7th floor. And option E. None is true. Let's see the solution. Option A. Q lives on 6th floor. Here in diagram, Q lives on 7th floor. So option A is not true. Option B. A lives on 2nd floor. Here in diagram, A lives 1st floor. So option B is not true. Option C. V lives on 4th floor. Here in diagram, V lives 3rd floor. So option C is not true. Option D. T lives on 7th floor. Here in diagram, T lives on 5th floor. So the option D is not true. So the answer is option E. None is true. Question number 4. How many persons live between R and Q? Options are option A, 1, option B, 2, option C, 3, option D, none, and option E, more than 3. Let's see the solution. Here in diagram, R lives on 2nd floor and Q lives on 7th floor. Here in between R and Q, 4 floors are there. So the answer is option E, more than 3. Question number 5. X lives on which of the following floors? Options are option A, 2nd floor, option B, 4th floor, option C, 3rd floor, option D, 6th floor, and option E, none of these. Let's see the solution. Here, X lives on 6th floor. So the answer is option E, sixth floor. Join today in Chennai Race Institute and learn from the experts. Thanks for watching.